Alright, on the screen we have given the binary operation star and delta. In this particular example, now we have two binary operations. Now star is defined as A star B. You can see on your screen our A star B is given as A plus B minus 2. That's for the operation star. And the other operation is delta, M delta N is given as 3M plus N minus 5. Now of course we have about 8 questions there for us to evaluate. Now why I made it up to 8 is such that I can explain all the necessary ingredients of a question as far as binary operations are concerned. So we have A star B as A plus B minus 2, and we have M delta N as 3M plus N minus 5. Now we are to evaluate the following: 2 star 1 minus 4 delta 3 and the rest of it. Okay, so let's solve. Our A star B is given as A plus B minus 2, and of course M delta N is given as, our M delta N is given as 3M plus N minus 5. So we have 3M plus N minus 5. Okay, so the first question we have there, where we are expected to evaluate, is 2 star 1. That's A. We are to evaluate 2 star 1. Alright, so our 2 star 1 becomes 2 star 1. Now, since we have two binary operations here, one is star. So 2 star 1 means we'll be solving where we have star. Okay, that's the first binary operation. Okay, so that means our 2 is now A and our 1 is now B. Take note, the binary operation was A star B. First operand was A and the second one was B, defined as A plus B minus 2. So now that we have 2 star 1, our first operand now is also 2 and our second operand is 1. So where we have A plus B now becomes 2 plus 1 then minus 2. Okay, the minus 2 is a constant in that binary operation. So we only replace the values for A and B as 2 and 1 respectively. Okay, so this is going to give us 2 plus 1 is 3 minus 2 is 1. Alright, so 1 is the value for 2 star 1 using the binary operation A star B, being defined as A plus B minus 2. Alright, the next one we have on the question list is B, which is minus 4 delta 3. So we have to evaluate minus 4 delta 3. Minus 4 delta 3. Now this equals to, of course, the second binary operation is for delta. M delta N is defined as 3M plus N minus 5. So minus 4 delta 3. Minus 4 is down the value for M, and of course 3 is down the value for N, replacing the first and the second operands for that binary operation respectively. Alright, so this equals to 3M now becomes 3 times minus 4, since M is the first operand and is given as minus 4 here, plus N is the second operand here, which is 3 of course. Then we have minus 5 being a constant. Okay, so this equals to 3 times minus 4 of course is minus 12 plus 3 minus 5, which is equals to minus 12 plus 3 of course will give us minus 9, and minus 9 minus 5 will give us minus 14. So this equals to minus 14 as the value for minus 4 delta 3. Alright, now the second example we have there, the second question is for us to find 3 star 2 then delta 5. Now in this scenario you can see that we can actually join the two binary operations together in a particular question. So we have 3 star 2 in a bracket then delta 5. So what we do here is to find 3 star 2 first, which is our bracket. Then we now use that answer to evaluate with delta 5. Okay, so C is for us to find 3 star 2 delta 5. We have 3 star 2 then delta 5. We can't take care of all the 3 operands at a time, so we pick just the bracket, which is 2 operands, 3 star 2, and we define using the binary operation star. Alright, our A star B was equal to A plus B minus 2, so 3 star 2 is also equal to 3 plus 2 minus 2, which is equal to 3 plus 2 is 5 minus 2 will give us 3 back. So we have 3 as 3 star 2. Now that was for the bracket 3 star 2. The question asks us to evaluate 3 star 2 delta 5. So this our bracket now is now given as 3 as an answer. Okay, so we now have delta 5. So this equals to 3 delta 5, Delta is now the second binary operation defined as m delta n to be equal to 3m plus n minus 5. So 3 delta 5, 3 will replace m and 5 will replace the second operand, which is n. Okay, so we have 3 times m is 3, then plus n is 5, then minus 5. So this is equal to 5 minus 5 of God, of course, is gone. Then what we have is just 3 times this 3 left, which of course is equal to 9. So that becomes the evaluation for 3 star 2 delta 5. Always take care of the bracket first, then use that answer to now evaluate with the other guy. Now back to our question list. The next one is now delta inside the bracket and star outside the bracket. So D, now we have to evaluate 2 delta 4 then star 1. 2 delta 4 star 1. Alright, so we can solve that. Of course, as our A star B, permit me to write this again. This is my next page. My A star B was equal to A plus B minus 2. And of course, M delta N was equal to 3M plus N minus 5. Now, question D, we have to evaluate 4 delta 2 delta 4 star 1. 2 delta 4 star 1. So we take care of the bracket first, which is 2 delta 4. Okay, so our binary operation now D is 2 delta 4 then star 1. Alright, so I'm going to solve 2 delta 4 first, which is equal to, so I'll be using the second binary operation, which is what was defined as delta. Alright, so we have 3m. M here is 2, which is the first operand. So we have 3 times 2, then plus n. N is the second operand, which is 4, then minus 5. So this is equal to 3 times 2, of course, is 6, plus 4 minus 5. So 6 plus 4 will give us 10. Then, of course, minus 5 will give us 5. So that is the value for 2 delta 4 star 1. You find the bracket first, and of course, after you've gotten an answer to that bracket, you now use it to evaluate with what is outside the bracket. Alright, our E, we are asked to find the identity element under star. We are asked to find the identity element under star. Don't forget what I said in the previous sessions, that when you are looking for identity, the identity is always a number that when you operate with another number, it doesn't change the number. 2 plus 0 is 2, making 0 the identity. And 2 times 1, of course, is 2, making 1 the multiplicative identity. Alright, so for us to be able to find the identity element as far as star is concerned, we define a property that says that A star E should be equal to A. I call the identity E, such that when I use it to operate with A, it will always return A. 2 plus 0 is 2, making 0 the identity. In this case, my identity is E. So A star E should always return A, making E the identity. Alright, so I'm going to define A star E with respect to the operation star on the screen. My A star B was A plus B minus 2. So that means that A star E, E has now replaced B. So A star E will now give us A plus E minus 2. And of course, this is equal to A. Because what I wrote earlier was A star B. Sorry, A star E is equal to A. So defining A star E, I have to equate it to A. Alright, so we now saw what we have here, which is E minus 2 is equal to A minus A. I'm taking this A on the left hand side to the other side, so I have A minus A. So that means that E minus 2 is equal to A minus A is 0. Alright, now if I make E the subject, I have E is equal to 0 plus 2. That is minus 2 crosses the equality sign to the other side as plus 2. So this implies that our E is equal to 0 plus 2, of course, is equal to 2. So as far as star is concerned, 2 is the identity element as far as the operation star is concerned. I'm sure that is very clear. If we are asked to find the identity element under delta, identity now for delta. Okay, now what we had was m delta n to be equal to 3m plus n minus 5. So I'm looking for the identity element under delta. So I also define it as m delta e should be equal to m. M delta e should be equal to m. Alright, so I'll find m delta e using my binary operation star, which is what we had here, binary operation, sorry, binary operation delta, not star. We are done with star. So I have M delta E. M is still my first operand, and the second operand is now replaced as E, which stands for the identity. Alright, so 3M now remains 3M plus N is now E, which is the second operand now, minus 5. And this should be equals to, this of course should be equals to what we have on the right hand side, which is M. M delta E should be equals to M. Alright, here I'll be making E the subject. Alright, so I have E minus 5 is equals to M. This 3M to this side will become minus 3M. So that means E minus 5 is equals to M minus 3M will give us minus 2M. Alright, I now transfer minus 5 to the other side. So I have E to be equals to minus 2M plus 5. Of course, that becomes our identity. Now here we still have M inside there, because after subtracting 3m from m, we're having minus 2m, so m is still available, unlike the previous one where a minus a gave us 0, but here m is still there. All right, so our identity element is written in terms of m, because m is still present on the right hand side. So the identity under the operation delta, of course, is minus 2m plus 5. All right, g is for us to find the inverse of 2 under star. We're looking for the inverse of 2 under star. Alright, and our star was defined as A star B to be equals to A plus B minus 2. Now I'm looking for the inverse of 2. I can say, okay, let the inverse of 2 be anything, we can call it P. So let the inverse of 2, let the inverse of 2 be equals to P. Alright, so I'm going to have 2 star P to be equals to E. Anytime you are trying to find the inverse, you always operate it and equate it to the identity. Now 2 minus 2 will give me 0, making minus 2 the additive inverse of 2, returning 0, which was the additive element. So inverse should always give you the identity left. So I'm defining 2 star P, where P is my inverse of 2, and I must equate it to identity. Don't forget what we solved earlier. Now what we solved earlier, the identity element for star was 2, as you can see on the screen. That's question E, when we're asked to find the identity element under star. We had 2 as the answer, so that's what we'll be using here. Alright, so we have 2 star P to be equals to, 2 is now our first operand, that's replacing A, and B is now our second operand, replacing B, of course, in this binary operation, A star B. So we have that 2 star P is now equals to A plus B is now 2 plus P, then minus 2 is equals to E, and E of course in this case also gave us 2. We had 2 as the value of E from what we solved earlier. Alright, so here we can have this to be equals to, now 2 minus 2 can just go here at once, so P here is equals to 2. So the inverse of 2, as far as that operation is concerned, is still equals to 2. Alright, and finally on the screen you can see that we are asked to find the inverse of 5 under the operation delta. We are asked to find the inverse of 5 under the operation delta. Alright, our operation delta was defined as M delta N to be equals to 3M plus N minus 5. Don't forget our identity element when we solved earlier for our delta, the operation delta was minus 2M plus 5. That was our identity element, so that's what we'll be equating it to. So our identity here was minus 2m plus 5. Alright, so let the inverse of 5 now be q. So we can call the inverse of 5 q. Let the inverse of 5 be given as q. So what we are now looking for here is m delta q should be equal to the identity, which is e. Okay, so we now define m delta q as 3m plus q. Take note, q is now our second operand, replacing m. Alright, then minus 5 is still a constant from the binary operation, and this equals to the identity element, which is minus 2m plus 5. Okay, so here we are trying to make q the subject. So we have q to be equals to, we transfer minus 5 to the other side and also transfer 3m to the other side. So we are going to have q to be equals to 3m plus 5 then minus 5 to this side is plus 5, and also plus 3m to this side is minus 3m. So our Q now, permit me to take it up, our Q now is equals to minus 2m plus, minus 3m. Minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5. So we have minus 5m, and of course, the constant inside there is 5 plus 5, which is equals to 10. So we have plus 10. So Q equals to minus 5 plus 10, of course, is the inverse of 5 as far as the operation delta is concerned. Ladies and gentlemen, that has been an intensive session as far as binary operations is concerned. Don't forget, this is about the third session, I think the fourth, where I have extensively discussed what binary operations are all about. I started by, talking about the theories of numbers and of course properties of numbers before we went on to discussing what a binary operation is. As a rule, that we always combine two values at a time to give a single value. I also mentioned the properties of binary operations, and of course in this particular session I was trying to help you solve some mathematical problems involving binary operation. At this point in time, I have full confidence that you can comfortably handle any question you see, from any exams as far as binary operations are concerned. Anyone, of course, you cannot. In the comment section of this video, you can always post as many questions as you have, and I'm sure by the interest we have in you, and also helping you to achieve your academic dreams, I'm going to be available to answer all the questions you post in the comment section. Alright, see you in the next tutorial session as we'll be taking other topics in order to further help you in this area.